Now, many patients have the erroneous assumption that medications such as Propecia and Rogaine don't work on the front of the scalp. The problem is that the medicines were originally tested just in the back of the scalp, and so the FDA limits the claims that they can make on what they can say. But all of us that use these medications know that they work in the front of the scalp just as well in the back. The important thing, though, is that they don't grow hair on bald scalp. What these medications do is reverse the miniaturization process. When you're losing your hair, you don't go from a full head of hair to being bald. Gradually, what happens is the hairs decrease in length and in diameter. And this thinning process called miniaturization is what eventually ends up in baldness. And while the hair is thinning, there's a window for the medications to reverse it, to actually elongate the hair and increase its thickness. And both Propecia and Rogaine will work to do this regardless of whether this process is going on in the back or the front of the scalp. So if someone tells you that, oh, you should have surgery because the medicines don't work in the front, say, whoa, let's give the medicines a try. And it's also important to have these medications be tested at least for a year. The medications work very slowly, you know, as does surgery. You know, surgery takes a year to grow in, so you can't rush these things. But after using both Propecia and Rogaine for a year, then we'll have some sense of whether we've exhausted our medical options, and then go to the next step, which would be a hair transplant. There's been a lot of publicity about the side effects of Propecia. Propecia does have side effects, perhaps in about 5% of patients. There have been some very rare cases of side effects persisting after the medications have been stopped, and this is, of course, a big concern. And we've been looking into this in detail. The cases seem to be very rare. And it's not clear always whether there's a cause and effect relationship, whether the medication is actually causing the persistence, or there may be some other reasons. Examples of other reasons could be certainly a psychological effect after the medicine is stopped, or that the patient would have sexual dysfunction from some other cause. Sexual dysfunction is relatively common, especially as people get older. And so it's very important to put everything in perspective. Unfortunately, it's very difficult to show cause and effect in this situation, and a lot more data needs to be accumulated to try to sort out what exactly is going on.